Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to create and position an organization chart using the Syncfusion Angular Diagram component. Look at this example. You can see the organization chart displaying information about company employees. The nodes and connectors are customized with different colors. Okay, first I will show you how to add a JSON data source to the Angular Diagram component using my existing Angular application. I open the application to which I have added the diagram with height and width properties. I also imported the required module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagram package. Follow the link provided in the card above or description below to learn the basics of adding the Angular Diagram to an app. Now, I will run this example using the command ng-serve. Looking at the output page, the diagram canvas is rendered with a defined height and width. You know that the Angular Diagram features are separated into individual modules. So, if I want to bind the data source and set specific layout type in the diagram, I need to inject their required services. Now, I am going to bind a JSON data source to the diagram component. First, I need to inject the data binding module from the Syncfusion Diagram package. As I said before, I want to show an organization chart, so I defined the object variable employee data with three fields: name, role, and reporting person. Then, I need to configure the newly created JSON data in the diagram to generate nodes and connectors automatically using mapping properties. To map the data source, I define another variable named JSON data source settings with the properties ID and parent ID to set unique IDs for the data items and define the relationship among the items based on those unique IDs. Next, I add a data source property and assign the collections of objects using a data manager. To access this data manager, I need to import it from Syncfusion data package. Now, I assign this JSON data source settings variable to the data source settings property. To use an organization chart, I need to inject the hierarchical tree module from the Syncfusion diagram package. Then, I define the variable layout settings of type layout model and add the type property with the value organization chart to set the organization chart as the layout. Also, I have imported the layout model from the Syncfusion diagram package. Next, I will assign this variable to the layout property. See the diagram canvas now. The nodes and connectors were automatically generated based on the data items in the data source. But if you look at the node, the employee names are not shown here. To display the employee names, I need to set annotation content for the node. First, I define the method defaultNodeValues, which receives an argument of type NodeModel, and import the node model interface from the Syncfusion Angular Diagram package. Within this method, I add the default node annotations property and define the content property. Next, I will export the employee info interface and define the parameter name within it to get the data values. Then, I will convert the node data to employee info type and set appropriate value to it to get the appropriate node data at runtime. I am also going to add a height and width with appropriate values and return the values using the default node parameter. I assign this method to the getNodeDefaults property of the diagram component. And now, you can see that the nodes render with the default node height and width values. Notice here that textual annotations are displayed inside the nodes. Looking at the connectors, they are not properly aligned. If I want to align them properly, then I need to set a type for the connectors. First, I define the method defaultConnectorValues, which receives an argument of type connectorModel, and import this interface from the Syncfusion Angular Diagram package. Within this method, I add the default node type property and set the value to orthogonal. Then, I return the values using the default connector parameter. Now, I assign this method to the getConnectorDefaults property of the diagram component. So now, you can see the diagram component, the connectors are aligned properly. Next, I will show you how to customize the node and connectors. I want to customize the node with a background color and display a textual annotation in white. So, within this default node values method, I define the style property and set appropriate values for the fill, stroke color, and stroke width properties. To display white font, I set the color property to white here. Next, to show connectors in a different color, I define the style property with a custom stroke color and stroke width within this default connector values to change the appearance of the connector path. Then, I want to change the target decorator for the connector. So, within this style property, I define the fill and stroke colors with custom values. Also, I make sure that the default node values and default connector values are assigned to get node defaults and get connector defaults, respectively. Now, you can see the diagram component displays the customized nodes and connectors. Notice here, the grid lines are visible in the diagram component. Suppose, I want to display the diagram canvas without grid lines. I define a variable, remove grid lines of type snap settings model, and import this interface from the Syncfusion diagram package. Then, I need to import the snapping service and inject the same in the providers array. To remove the grid lines, I need to set the constraints to none. I have imported the snap constraints enum from the Syncfusion diagram package to set the none value here. Now, I assign this variable to the snap settings property of the diagram component. Look at the output page now. The diagram canvas displays without grid lines. Next, I will show you how to bind a remote data source to the diagram component. First, I define the object variable remote data source and add the properties ID, parent ID, and data source. I am going to display the organization chart of the specific company. Therefore, I define the properties URL and cross-domain. In the URL, I will be using the already available remote URL service, which will retrieve the list of data through a post action and then bind the resultant data to the diagram. The cross-domain option is set to true to allow cross-origin domain requests. Then, I need to write a query to fetch the data. I use select query to get the data inside the constructor. And I also need to import the query class from the Syncfusion data package to access it. Next, I set the ID to employee ID and parent ID to reports too, to show the relationship between the employees based on ID value. Along with this, I also need to change the annotation content for the node. So, let me first export the data info interface and define the parameter like this. Then, I will change the annotation content of the node by converting the data as data info class and set appropriate field name to it. Next, I will assign this remote data source variable to the data source settings property. You can see on the diagram canvas that the nodes and connectors are generated based on the remote data source. In this video, we saw how to populate JSON and remote data sources to the Syncfusion Angular Diagram component. We saw how to customize the nodes and connectors. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.